I've been born and bred on the land. The land means a lot to me. The trees, my grandchildren know all the trees because I teach them, and they know the black boys because they're so beautiful. We have a paddock full, and we put a fire through this paddock, and the plant is native to Australia, and especially at Mount Perry. And it looks so magnificent with the glows that it was giving on the afternoon that I painted it. I've worked the land all my life. I've lived it and breathed it. I've been through flood, fire and famine. We have been riding the paddocks, dead cattle. And the movement in the land is exquisite. I had to do a painting relating to music. And I experimented with this painting, with all my mixtures and mediums. And this is what I exhaled, with all the little dots and up and down, and this hence comes the rhythm of the land, which I'm very passionate about. Well, the Outback Aussie is a landscape, funny enough. Again, I was playing. I had been working at the show and I hadn't did any painting, so I started playing again, and I promised myself I would never paint Ayers Rock. And so I was mixing my colours and playing around with it, and when I paint, I've got to lay it down and stand it up, and when I stood it up, I seen Ayers Rock, and I thought, oh, I wasn't going to do that. But it just happened. So my innermost feelings had come through.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Moonwalk was named because I took it to the framers, and there was a gentleman there, and he says, oh, wow, Moonwalk. And I, oh, there's its name. And he just fell in love with it. It's all craters on the moon, red paint coming through with gold paint, and it was just exquisite. So that's why I named it Moonwalk. It's very important to me writing out because it is my son, and that's what I've done all my life, is ride out to work. Horses and men have been my life. The cattle yards, the mustering of cattle, my father instilled this into us, so I am very passionate about my sons, and I do a lot of paintings with them. Again, because I'm off the land, my husband laughs. I needed a palette, so I grabbed his thong and used it. I seen this corrugated iron laying around the sheds at the farm. I can use that. So I grabbed it in and painted on it, put my special technique on it, and it was hard to work because of the corrugated, so I had to go with it and play, and this was the outcome of this painting, and again it won a first prize. So it was really pleasing to see my efforts and my playfulness is coming to the fore.